Hello.
A warm welcome to everyone. In continuation to my earlier lecture of ligand preparation, where I taught you how to sketch molecules for docking using a freely available softwares, in the current lecture I will be teaching you how to prepare ligands by using a proprietary software called Schrodinger Maestro. So this is a evaluatory version. Now let us see how we will do by using Schrodinger. In general, for any ligand preparation, you require a ligand. Now that is a two-dimensional molecule. First thing is, the docking is of two types. One is a rigid docking and another one is a flexible docking. What do you mean by rigid docking? Where you put your protein as a rigid one, and whereas your ligand is a flexible one. Sometimes you put both ligand and protein both as flexible. So for that, whatever the ligand is there, you need a multiple conformations. That means a single ligand molecule which is two dimensional may have different conformers in three dimensional form. So for that, you need to sketch your molecules in various conformations, either stereocenters or by tautomers or any other ways. Now the first and foremost thing is, here whatever I am teaching you today is by Schrodinger Maestro. The first one is, you have to go for application. In that application, you have to select ligand preparation. After selecting lig prep, you get a small window. In that, it will ask where to choose structures, either from workspace entries. Whatever the molecules appended in the workspace, it will select that, or you can import from a file which is either from your desktop or from anything, simply input, or from project table selected entries. What do you mean by project table selected entries? Means you have a project already running, or you want a new project where you want to select molecules. For example, go to the project table here. In this project table, see, you do not have anything. So now I am importing a new molecules into this. Now go for file. Now you go simply import structures. Now by importing structures, you can select any two-dimensional structures. Now the structure is already imported into your format. Now if you see what structures are displayed here, is one is the structures which are two structures are there. One is structure salt one and another one is imidazole one. By default, these are not highlighted, but once you select these molecules, either by control or by simply by mouse click, they get their background get highlighted. See, now again, once I have selected both, now both the backgrounds have been highlighted. The first and foremost thing is, in ligand preparation, you have to filter the ligands based upon some descriptors. So why there is a need of filtration? So if you do not filter it, so what happens is, if the molecule weight is more, that means if there is any Lipinski variation, these molecules cannot be druggable. The first and foremost thing is, these many descriptors are available in Schrodinger. So you can select any descriptors, that is molecular formula, molecular weight, molecular number, heteroatoms, etc. So in the current case, I am explaining you a select molecular weight. Suppose I input a molecular weight ranging from 150 to 450. So by doing all these things, what happens is that, by default, Schrodinger selects only molecules in between 150 and 450 and excluding molecules which have less than 150 molecular weight and which is having more than 450 molecular weight. This is the fundamental aspects of ligand filtering. So there are several descriptors. So be these descriptors, you can screen. At the same way, keeping the Lipinski parametric functions, you should add descriptors. Second thing is functional group counts. So if your molecule have functional groups, okay, or else you can add new functional groups by selecting these elements, as well as now you can create a new ligand library. So this is also one of the filtration or addition criteria. Next thing is force field analysis. Now what is force field? In force field, whatever the two-dimensional structure is there, it is rigid one. Now there is a three-dimensional conformation of that molecule by using force field. There are several force field, that is MM2, OPLS and several other force fields to minimize the structures. Next one is ionization. Now in the ionization, why you need ionization? Because these molecules, when have enter into the body, may have different environments. So based upon your requirement, you should select. So either you should select do not change, that means whatever the default structures you drawn, the same ionization will be there, or you put neutralize, that means whatever the ionization was available, you will remove them, or generate possible states in between 7 and 2. What does it mean is, so the ionization states are generated by using some algorithms, so that ionization of molecules based upon the requirement of proteins. So first thing is, you need to know what type of target you are targeting, whether you need ionization or not. That is the fundamental aspects of ligand preparation. Now in ionization part, there are two ways. One is by using ionizer or by using epic mode. So by the Mastro, the ionizer is the slowest one, whereas the epic is the fastest and more reliable part in ligand preparation. Second thing is whether you have to keep metal binding states. That means if you have iron, suppose your molecules are ferrocene or any other molecules, so we have to see whether the metal binding states should be kept in your molecules or not, include original state. So these are the parametric parts to screen your ligands. Next one, the next parameter is desalt. That means if your molecule is in salt form, the next one is you will simply select desalt that molecule, or generally go for generate tautomers. Now what are tautomers? Tautomers are conformations of molecules with which there are different states are generated. Next one is we go for stereoisomeric centers. Now what are stereoisomers? So whatever the molecules you have sketched, if you have any isomeric forms, now either you can go for retain specified chiral centers or determine chiralities from 3D structure. What does it mean? Whatever the molecule is there, once your 2D molecule is converted into 3D by Mastro, it itself generates some chiralities in the molecules, and various chiral orientation of the molecules are created in output. Or you can go for generate all combinations. That means it will fix the specified chiralities as well as it will create various combination of chiralities. So this is your whatever you prefer, you can select. The next one is generate how many stereoisomers per ligand. This is your choice. Either you can create 32 or 100 or 1000. By default, the Mastro or Schrodinger says generate 32 chiralities or stereocenters per ligand. Again, you have one more pattern of generating standard definition enantiomeric forms. However, we are not doing that. Now you go for generate low energy conformers. So these low energy conformers, either you can put 1 or 100, even more than 100. So now generally we are putting, the output is generally saved in either Mastro or in SDF format. Now simply we select any either of the formats, and generally we go and click for run. Now once you click run, your job is started. You will have a job name. So that is like prep one. Now you can also monitor the ongoing you can put any other names, ongoing jobs, by seeing the window of jobs at the bottom of the Mastro, and simply by clicking that Mastro jobs, you will go to the file and you can see the status of running. Now you go for click monitor. Now you simply see that the start time and end time of your ligand preparation. Now once it completes, the file will get opened. Now you see that it is like prep has been completed. Now it will show you how many ligands have been successful in preparation, how many ligands have been failed. So what are the stereocenters that have been added, what we have been specified, so is there any problems in the structure. Everything will be simply displayed in the output of Mastro. Next thing is, now we have to open the output file and we have to see what type of the how many different conformers of the ligand which it has been generated. For that, what we need to do, open the folder into which our ligand output was created and generally visualize how many stereo forms or how many conformers it has been generated. Second thing is, after generation, see, now if you see these many variable, now these are the first two forms of the input which have been given earlier. If you watch the first stages of the video, and the next one are the output forms. What are the output forms? How many output forms are there? You can simply see these many output forms are there. Salt variable, tautomers, ionization variables, and by using any of these or simply by selecting all, you can run a ligand and which can be used for further process of docking. This is the fundamental aspects of preparation of ligand using Schrödinger Mastro.